All right, guys. So, sorry for that break in transmission. Just to make sure you don't have that buffering stuff. I need to just touch something. All right. Like we said, Ernest Lozin, our student, just three months, he has been with us on Skype. And then, so great. Us on Skype is so effective. I didn't even time my read. Can you imagine? Okay, just 1 minute. Now play the song again. Play that song again. Great is thy faithfulness. That place is La Ti Terra. Now that place you play me. Right now play. Right now. Again. Very good. Don't practice, don't be doing that grace note. That's very good. Let me play it now for you guys. No. Don't rush it. I told you that. Tongue in to separate that do la is it?
Gotcha.
So, la la. me play now. Vibrato is very important. Vibrato is very important. Make sure you have. Do you understand? When you go. Just go. Just end the song as a song. That three times of going. That is when you want to end the song. Do you understand?
Okay.
When you want to end the song, you just go. La ti do do so so mi fa dire more do. That is you just play the song.
Just play the song.
But when you are performing the song and you now, suppose what are you doing on that camera?
Okay.
He's not blowing, but you are on that camera. That's when you want to end it.
Yeah, end it, yeah.
Towards the end. Maybe you have taken it like three times, four times.
To do it already.
You have done the song. Now you want to just end it. There is thy faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Great is your faithfulness. Lord unto me. But when somebody asks you to play the song, you don't need to do those
things. Got it.
So play it now. Just play the song now. Have timing in your mind. If you're going to draw that song, make sure you don't draw it out of time.
Okay.
For example, I'm going. If I'm going to do it like this, that means you have to be in time. Now, play it now like you have a backing instrument.
Okay.
Because the most important aspect of this physical contact is to make sure that we have that audience there. The reason why he had to come, apart from just
Skype.
Just trying to see where God is doing this great work, is for him to come and then to play with other bands. We can't do that on Skype, two of us. On Skype, there is going to be a little delay of audio, of sync.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So it can't be there all over there, and I'm playing beat for him,
yeah.
And then there's going to be a delay, you know, video in network
yeah.
is going to delay. Just like, for example, if I say tap, maybe possibly they tap, then you hear tap. So there's no how I'll be able to do what we're about to do now if on Skype. So on Skype, he's alone in trying to use metronome to practice a song. But since you came now, we've been doing practically playing with other instrumentalists playing with him. Now, that is very key. I think we're drum now. Start again now. Now you go. Except you just want to play with keyboards.
Yeah.
A keyboard. With that, just as if you are playing
just a keyboard. Okay.
Let me be on keyboard and then you play.
Okay.
That one you take and put your you can even run your leagues and fields in between. Let's go now. Let me be on keyboard.
I got you. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
I'm coming. Okay, let's go. The pianist to give you.
So if I'm playing C right now.
You are playing C, yes.
So if we're doing semitone, halftone, halftone, the keyboard is gonna play key D. No, key A. No, wait. Semitone, C.
So okay, now this is an E flat instrument.
E-flat. Yeah.
Now you are about to go and play in a concert. Mm-hmm. Now you need to understand that this is an E flat instrument.
Oh, that means.
Why is it an E flat instrument? When you are playing your key C. The piano is going to be playing the name of the...
So D-sharp.
D-sharp, yes, which is E-flat. Now, that means the pianist is how many semitones ahead of you? Three. That means from C, he's going to jump C-sharp, D, D-sharp. He's going to go one, two, three.
Got it.
So any key you are, tell the guy to go one, two, three semitones. And then if you are on key F, what key is going to be playing?
Key F?
You are on key F. He's going to play F sharp, G, G sharp. So he's going to play G sharp. So which key should I play for you right now?
D sharp.
D sharp. So all right, let's go. G sharp.
D sharp.
Now, before you play, just run some fifth right now. But you know, one thing that is going to make this the tone very emotional is your vibrato.
Okay.
This is where you want to use your vibrato. When they were playing on beats, vibrato will not be as important as it is when you just needed a pianist to play with you. So start all over again and play it with vibrato. Play demonstrate vibrato. Let me see.
Again,
very good. That's very, very good.
Oh my God.
That is very good. That's very good, man. Oh all right, guys. God. You see, you see, what we're just doing here now is to put together vibrato. You learned it. Mm-hmm. You know, grace note. You learned it.
Yeah.
You need to be able to put everything now
together.
Yeah. Especially, what that's what we now call articulation. Now, I want you to be able to improvise this song. How do you not improvise this song? Well, you just play this straight.
Yeah.
Now, Vera Sax is going to improvise. I'm not going to play. Vera Sax, play the song and improvise. Now, Vera Sax is going to help you put one or two licks inside Great is Thy Faithfulness.
Okay.
There's no point in rushing the song. Let's just stay on this particular song.
Yeah.
And then, you know, we get the best out of this song. Now, Vera Sax. Great is your
that's the lyrics, man.
Vera Sax, that's the lyrics Vera Sax wanna do, you know? Great lyrics, you know? So la do la do le mi mi so mi so la do la do te re da mi re da mi re do la do. Correct. See, that is the lyrics. You go up, you come down. You stay down, you go up. You go up, you come down. Just then you use grace note to come down, you know, some licks, permutations.
So her first lick was.
Yeah. But what you do is that you don't rush it. Because you are now on the blues level. If you just go, guys, the tempo in which she was doing it was cooler and more in relationship with the kind of music she wanted to do than the way you just do. So do it now. No.
The way I want you to do it.
No, not too dull again. So that you don't da-da-da-da-da. No. If I want to do it, I won't say, I'll not just go. Because I'm not about to run. It's a cool music, blues, just you and piano. It's called a just medley kind of something. You see, I've articulated it now. Some notes, I draw it. Some notes, I just, you know, left it. Look at it. You see, I stayed on a note. I stressed it. Apostle, I'm talking. My mouth. I stressed it. You don't understand? So.
So how slow did you do in the beginning?
Look at it. That gives you room to put the vibrato that will thrill the audience.
Yeah.
All right, Vera Sax, over to you. Let's listen to Vera Sax first. Went repetitions. Pick, since you are not bound to beat, and you are just the pianist just following you. Versa, I was saying, if I was the one that was doing that part, I'll go. Just do some repetitions there. So.
Yeah.
Vanessa, something happened to you. What happened to you? Now, sometimes she wanted to go, you know, some improvisation, and she lost her way. Vanessa lost her way in the chorus.
Yeah.
So, you know, you have to be a little bit conscious, because sometimes you want to go and run some scale, and you forgot where.
Yeah.
Another thing you will do is that you will quickly listen back to the pianist. Which note is he? Some pianists will give you some, you know, just give you some idea. Because now, this is. Now where you go. That is fine. And then when I get to the second. Great is that. So you first of all play it, you know, without the beat, the full instrument, just piano, so that you can express yourself. So let's go now. Let me do my own licks now before I start. Press a chord on that, you know it will go off. Now, the mi fa, so fa, mi, I can now run a lick there to replace that note. I'll go. You know that lick now?
Yeah.
So do fa mi, do so fa mi, do. I just use it to replace. That's all I replace, because it's all in the major. So even if I replace it with it, it is okay.
Yeah.
So I go. Why did I go to T.A.T. at last? Because the song is. It landed on Re, and I taught you what? Arpeggio.
Yeah.
When I land on Re, I can go T, I can go Sol.
Yeah.
So go. That's arpeggio now. So, I run a pigeon to do, so me, so do. You see the chord I played, is that okay?
Yeah.
So go. That's a pigeon. The song landed on me. I take it to do. I bring me to so. I go to me. Me, so do. I just play the chord of the song. So let me go now. Another way to improvise that your fifi, that your note, is to go. To fi, I did the grace note of the fi, I brought it to this one, and then like that, so. I can stay here and expect some claps from the audience.
Yeah.
Because imagine I'm going and I start going. Why did I go family so? I just pick a note of that last one and I begin to repeat it, expecting a clap from the audience. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. carrying it like this with a minor, which I thought you just go do re mo fa so fa so mi mi mo re do do. Play that again. Let me see. Learn that lick now. Everybody play that lick. Do take it one after that. You go. You go. That's all. No, no delay. No delay. Do. No, no, no. You don't need C sharp yet. Play the song all through the song now and then improvise while I work on that first camera. All right, let's go. Versax, over to you.
Woo, Versax.
Versax.
what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. You see, that's the lyrics he just used to end the song. Yeah. Now play the song and try and end it with that lyrics. Can you try?
Yeah, you try.
Yeah, viewers out there say Verasax is resting today. Verasax, there's no rest for Verasax. She's still going to.
Are you serious?
Yes. Someone said you are resting. So you are not resting. There's no rest for Verasax. So let's go now.
So, from the beginning?
Yes. That's also very good. So let's learn this song that you asked for. Hosanna.
That's not a kissy, right? No,
a kissy.
This song, you must be able to play it on two keys.
Yes, so let's try a different key.
Let's try a different key.
Yeah, let's try a different key.
You have to be able to play it on different keys. Yeah. But let me look for the key that is best for you.
Okay.
Let me look for the key that is going to be best for you. If that's a play for me on
4 minutes first.
Talking about now, this song, if you want to play the way it's done,
the way it's
that's
done.
Where you want to do it.
Yeah.
You know, you played it for me and you want to do it that way. Now, you're going to start from key C and play. Give me your key C. Hosanna in the highest. Ta da da ta da 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 da. Because Jonathan, so viewers out there, if you want to do this song, the way it's done is that you first of all play it on key C. No, you first go key C now is.
Thank you.
Yes, you understand how it's going now. Hmm?
Yeah.
Do you understand?
I get it. So first key C, then key A.
Yeah.
First key C, then. Then key A.
So
you have to learn key A right now.
Right.
Key A is, right, if now you learn key A, you're able to play, key A is the minor relative of key C.
Yeah.
And key C is also, they are minor related. So that's like they just dropped it into minor.
Okay.
Minor, lower. There is what you call minor. You go up, minor. You go lower, minor. Relative. Relative, minor, high. If I'm on key C, I'm on key A now. You know what I did? I was on key A, I now ran something on key C. That is the minor relative of my key A. But this song started from key C and dropped back
to key A.
Which is the original key they wanted to play it on. It's like playing something on the minor relative,
yeah.
Drop it down to the main minor. Then later, while the song is going on, they have the opportunity of going back to that same key C now and still improvise on that key C. You understand now? So I go. That's my new key. Back to my key C again. That's what they did in that song.
Okay.
Key C, you play the song. Key A, you play the song. Go back to key C and play the song. So you have, after the class, you're going to sit down and learn your key A. I'm going to teach you how to play your grace note there, how to transfer everything you have learned on key C. But we're just going to demonstrate so that we can go to another song. That's all now. When you come back to
key,
so that there will be, you know,
transmission.
Okay, now. I'm not supposed to go high. Even though it should be too. Okay, let's go again. Do you understand? Right.
Yeah.
So you go. From. So, all right, guys, I think, how many of my songs do you want to learn? So many other songs.
So yeah, many. Yeah. So many songs.
Okay, now, we are going to be back live again.
Okay.
I want to, I'm going to come back, guys, I'm really going to come back to, because I make up my mind that everything I'm teaching him in this is coming, it's going to be online. So I want him to go and practice key A now,
yeah.
And then we come back and do this song.
All right, guys,
all right, Vera Sax has something to say for this class.
So guys, as you can see, our Skype student is here with us, 101.
Yeah, that's good.
For those of you that are scared of Skype, it's very, very simple. Don't be scared. You can register. We'll get to you straight away. We are at your service anytime, any day. Stay tuned and keep learning. See you later. Bye.